Write my name in the book of life. I want my name to be there. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
See, I'm charging you this morning to take the book of 2 Timothy 3:1-7 and Proverbs 15:1-15 when you get home and compare. Because what I wanted to do initially was to do that comparison analysis one by one and see what Paul was telling Timothy about end time Christians. Oh God. I'm being careful how I pray these days, because if I say, Lord, give me the spirit of Paul, I don't think I have the spirit muscle. That is the Paul. And guess what? He schooled in the Harvard of his time. He had the best professor of his time. Yet, God withdrew him and turned him into a Fulani. All his life, till he died, he was moving from one place to another. And he recounted and said, when I read the things that happened to him, he was even keeping records. He said, twice I was beaten. 3 times I was jailed. Ha! And I imagine myself. Even Nigerian police said, I can't go. For the sake of Christ, can I? Can you? Hey! Umaroki, can you? Yes! The book of Luke chapter 6, I think verse 25, if I'm correct.
How terrible for you who are full
now. You will go hungry.
26.
How terrible when all people speak well of you. Okay. Their ancestors said the very same thing about the false prophets.
Okay, let's dial back. Mommy, I think we should go to 23.
Be glad when that happens.
Before that one.
Happy are you when people hate you, reject you, insult you, and say that you are evil.
Thank you.
All because of the Son of Man.
Thank you. Mommy, Ajoko. Now, in Nigeria, this is my own opinion, I still believe that the report of the Fulani killing Christian is unconfirmed. Yet, Christians are ready to come to the pulpit with knife and gun because they want to protect themselves. Sorry. Where is the blood of Jesus Christ if you want to carry gun? The first time Christ was sending his disciples out, he said, carry nothing. Second time he said, carry something. But there is something greater than any weapon that Christians have. It is love. It may sound impractical, but I tell you, it is love. If you read the book of 2 Corinthians 13, if you see how love is enumerated, you will fall in love with love. Serious. Say love covers all faults. So imagine you forgiving somebody before it happens. You decide in your mind that today, everybody that will offend me have forgiven you. So that when that person eventually hurts you, we do not give us spirit of love.
Amen.
See, for us to live a life that is aligned with the purpose of God, there is a need for us to dial back, to take a step back and think on the reason why we are before God. Time. I will end up, but not without upgrading my own list. See, there's a lot of things that we will say on the pulpit, and a lot that will be lost in translation, and a lot that will be lost after we leave this church, this building. But I trust somebody, I trust him, I trust him, I trust him, I trust, and he knows I trust him very well. I consider him in him, because he's my power. That is the Holy Spirit. Trust him very well. I trust him to stupidity. How many of us have tried that before? Trust the Holy Spirit to stupidity. Something is a small story. One guy was working in one tall building, and then he was the only one on site that day. Then he fell on like 300 story. And as he was falling, and he just used his hand and caught onto something, and he was hanging there. And while he was there, because he said, "Lord, help me. Lord, help me. Lord, help me. I'm about to die. Lord, help me." And then, Lord helped him. I said, "My son, yes, yes. Do you trust me?" He said, "Yes, Lord." He said, "Let go of your hand." Hey, God. I said, "My son, do you trust me?" He said, "Yeah, I trust you." He said, "Let go of your hand." He said, "Somebody else help me." They're laughing, but that is what we do. He said, if we take our time to read the Bible, we will marvel at how often we labor for nothing. He said, "My ways are not your ways. I don't operate with 5 senses. You do. You are limited by 5. I am unlimited. My power is not bound by the force of gravity. I do not operate with the laws of nature." So when nature says you will grow old, if I say you will stay young, nobody will fault it. You don't believe me? Ask me to sell her. When you see him in heaven, because me, I will see him.
Yeah,
it's unfortunate that God decided to remove him, because if not, a lot of us will go and meet him and ask, "Uncle, can't you give me the non-aging potion that you use and stay young?" Thank you. Oh, see, I'm sharing my spirit. Now, my recipe. Number one, the book of Proverbs chapter 15. I want us to read before I say it. Proverbs 15.
A gentle answer quickens.
15 verse 3.
The Lord sees what happens everywhere.
Thank you. Never forget that the Lord is present with you at all times. That's number one. You might want to write it down. That's the recipe for end time Christian. See, if we keep in our mind that God is with you at all times, not just to keep you from harm, but also to keep you from yourself. And you say, "Oh Lord, who are pelu me?" We usually say it in context of God is there to protect me, God is there to fight for me. How about God is there to stop you from committing sin? Gospel according to 2 children. Small children. Once I want to confess his own panel. She alone to our looking. Show me the number. I want to commit sin in our flight. Foolish. God is with you wherever you are, even when you are committing sin. Even when you are planning to commit, even when you are planning to plan to commit sin. Because everything starts from the mind. That's why he said, "Be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind." Topic for another day. Youth, Alapadi, yes. We'll discuss that. Because when you renew your mind, a transformation takes place, and people do not see you anymore. They see a brand new you and they ask, "What?" So number one, never forget that God is with you at all times. even when you are making decisions. The knowledge of that keeps you in check. Because most Christians were forgotten that silently, they shoot him at Bagby. We operate without care. We just do it. As our Nike, just do it. Just do it. Number two. Someone should open to the book of John, Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. Another person, 2 Timothy 3:16. Another person, Psalm 119 verse 9, I think. I can't see my own language. Joshua 1 verse 8.
Be sure that the book of...
depart out of thy mouth.
Aha.
For thou shalt meditate therein day and night.
Yes.
That thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein.
Yeah.
For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
Thank you, sir. Read the word of God. 2 Timothy chapter 3:16.
All scripture is given by inspiration.
Yes. Of
inspiration of God. And through, is profitable.
To.
Is profitable for doctrine.
Yes.
For reproof.
Yes.
Correction.
Yes.
For instruction.
Yes.
In righteousness.
And continue, sir. Go to the next verse. Okay. There's something there I want you to hear.
That the man of God
may
be perfect.
Hey.
Thoroughly.
Huh?
Furnished unto.
Thank you, sir. That the man of God will be perfect. That the woman of God will be perfect. See, let no man deceive you. When God said, be ye perfect as I, the Lord your God, is perfect, he ain't joking. Sorry, quickly bow down your head and say, oh no, must submit that. I don't know how to say that in English. For my tongue, because one more we pay on my bad, I don't get you. Ah, oh my bad. In Jesus' name we are prayed.
Amen.
He said that the man of God will be perfect. That the son of God, the daughter of God, will be perfect. Look. Have this understanding. Maybe I should have said it from the beginning. God and Christianity is not equal to boring life. Mm-hmm. You can boogie it in God. Do you know the funny way that God revealed that to me? I was back in Nigeria, I was driving, and I saw this, it was during Ramadan. And I saw this big bold signboard. And there was this beautiful Hausa-looking lady. Her head was covered. But every other thing was unlike the Islamic thing. And they wrote there, looking hip within the doctrine. Looking hip within the doctrine. As in looking chom chom, looking chingong. So, dear ladies, it's a pity that most of my youth ladies are not here today. You can look mwah without going naked.
Yeah.
The Bible says, let everything that you adorn yourself with, let it be in moderation.
Yes.
Believe me, if you keep it in moderate, men will roll over themselves for you.
Yes.
But when it is too much, they will... Wait a second. So, all scriptures are written through the inspiration of God. They are good for reproach, for rebuke, for so many things. So that you will turn the way of the Lord and be perfect. Psalm 119 verse 11.
Thy word have I had in my mind.
That I might not sin against you. Hey. See the reason why the psalmist said the word of God in his heart? That he will not sin. So it is expedient for us to keep the word of God in our heart always. And how do you do that? Practical Christianity. Look. Let me not deceive you. Half of us, even when we have the time to do devotion, We let devotion end at devotion. Fine. That is what the world has turned us to. But make it a point of duty. Try it today. Either from your devotion or out of your devotion, keep one verse of the Bible in your mind throughout the day. I've tried it before.
Yeah.
Crooked or straight, that verse will apply to everything you do that day.
Yeah.
Go and try it. One way or the other, you want to take a decision, you want to take the bus, you want to ride, you want to do anything. Just let that verse keep in your mind throughout the day. The next day, pick another one and another one. Before you know it, you will have been transformed by the renewing of your mind, because your head, your brain will be so filled with the word of God that there will be no space for the devil.
Amen.
Now, we don't watch TV tire. Don't do Facebook tire. Now, even Trump, some of us now, the screensaver of our phone, now Trump tweet page. Every time he tweets, he don't tweet. He's the tweeting president, so leave him on. Party. So let the word that floods your mind be that comes from God. There's a question in the Bible. Moshe asked his wife, Moshe blessed, but he said, let your word be seasoned with salt, filled with grace, so that you may know how to answer people. I think it's in the book of Colossians. Youth, we'll do Bible study. Not be joking. Say, so let your word. I now ask, why will Paul say my word should be seasoned with salt? Nasu. What?
Without the recipe.
Let's go to chemistry. What is the composition of salt? Something from another day. Thank you, sir. Number 3. Proverbs. Let me not go to it. Atishe.
Yes.
Proverbs 15 and Luke 6. See, practice the word of God. See, practice the word of God because your life depends on it. I wanted to say as if your life depends on it, but we know now that our life depends on it. Do not live in isolation of the Bible. Because when you do, you are leaving room for the devil to sow a seed in you. Why? Do you think I'm saying it? No. The Bible says, the kingdom of God is like unto a man that planted his field. And in the night, what happened? The enemy came and sowed. So, do not be deceived. I don't know how to say it in English. Or what about dealing? The Shumwa Shetan. The mind that is blank will definitely attract negative ideas. Thank you, sir. So, the moment you leave your mind blank, void of the word of God, the word of the devil will come. And guess what? The word of the devil is like the apple in the Garden of Eden. Very, very enticing. Holy Spirit, thank you. Last but not the least, Galatians chapter 5, verse 16. The same verse that we started with will end with it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Galatians 5, 16. Yes.
What I say is this.
Uh-huh.
Let the Spirit direct your life.
Uh-huh.
And you will not satisfy the desires of the human nature.
Mommy, thank you. Another translation.
This I say then.
Yes.
Walk in the Spirit.
Walk in the Spirit.
And ye shall not fulfill.
And you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Let's start on our face.
Stop it.
Emi ni mo agbara orun wa gbe ni wo.
wa gba ko so
ele mi ma para oru wa ge mi wo
emi orun wa
o ba wa pe oluwa wa da bi ara o lo ni o wa te emi orun wa
Now let us ask this morning. We've started a revival. So the first thing we want to do is asking for the Holy Spirit of God to direct us. Talk to